The last chapter of Titus, chapter 3, begins by saying this, remind them. It could be interpreted better by saying, keep reminding them to be subject to or obedient to rulers, authorities, to live life in a respectful, lawful, orderly way. See, the Cretans had some problems with authority. And he doesn't just say, you know, live by the rules, but he also says, be ready for every good work. Christianity is not just passive obedience to rules or things God has said to us, but it's also active involvement in things you know God has asked you to do and reveals to you day by day. Obey and serve might be another way to say it simply. And then he says, and let me read verse 2 to you. He says, speak evil of no one. Be peaceable, gentle, showing all humility to all men. This is kindness, a love not just from a good heart, but knowing who we are in Christ and who others are. They're loved and cherished by him as well. So he's saying, be peaceable. In fact, let me close with these verses. Listen to them. That kind of catches the heart of it. But when the kindness and love of God, our Savior, toward man appeared, not by works of righteousness which we had done, but according to his mercy, he saved us through the washing of the regeneration and renewing of the Holy Spirit, whom he poured out on us abundantly through Jesus Christ, our Savior. See, here's what he's saying. Live a certain way in obedience and orderly fashion. Love in a certain way because Christ loves them. Treat one another in a certain way. And it's all because what he's done for us, how he's poured his love and his grace and his mercy abundantly upon us. So he says, hey, because of what he's done, here's what we should be doing. And that's how he closes out chapter 3 of the book of Titus.